This is where East meets West in cyber terms, connecting millions of people around the world, and it's all controlled from the terminals in this room.
Worldwide, undersea cables carry 99% of intercontinental internet traffic, and one of the busiest hubs is right here in Egypt. The country has two main areas where cables come ashore, the Red Sea in the east and the Mediterranean in the north. And as you would expect, each landing station is in a near-secret location with tight security.
Few people get to visit this facility, and with good reason. In March 2013, Egypt's internet connectivity was severely disrupted after an undersea cable was severed.
Millions in Africa, the Middle East, and South Asia experienced severe internet disruption following the incident. And at the time, it was feared it could have been an act of cyber terrorism. However, Telecom Egypt believes the cable was accidentally cut by a commercial shipping vessel. The company has since received $12.5 million in compensation from a ship known only as B Elephant.
There's been substantial criticism about the lagging internet speeds in Egypt, which add to the cost of business. A Facebook page, Internet Revolution Egypt, even got hundreds of thousands of likes. What is being done to improve that bandwidth?
So, in fact, this is a very important issue, and myself and my team, you know, we listen very closely to this, and we will quickly analyze what has passed, not because we want to dwell on it, but because certainly we don't want to repeat it. Now, this is the price of taking Telecom Egypt out of everything that's modern, which is mobile, broadband, and offering data itself in the last 15 years. And what we're doing moving forward is we're operating as a total telecom operator. Right now, we have a license for fixed data and voice, and that's why we are moving very quickly with fiber rollout. We plan to address 4 of the 7 million homes that we serve with fiber to the curb and fiber to the home by December 2015. So we recognize the problem. Yeah. We admit that there is a problem.
There have also been sporadic disruptions to some of the main data access cables, which also serve as waypoints linking Asia with Europe. At some point, there was talk of saboteurs cutting these undersea cables. Then it was a tanker that pulled the cables out of the ground. What's the story here? And are these cables too vulnerable?
So this is an important point, and I'm happy to explain to you more about. Now, we have 1,000 kilometers of Red Sea shoreline and 1,000 kilometers of Mediterranean Sea shoreline. 18 different discrete submarine cables land on these shores, connecting Asia to Europe. A typical country would have 1 or 2 cables. So the number of cables in Egypt is just very large because of the fact that we connect Asia to Europe. In addition to this, usually a country's shorelines accessed by someone going to or leaving from that country. In our case, we're a passageway where all the shipyard that goes out of Asia crosses our channel in order to reach the Mediterranean onwards to Europe. So being a passageway and having so many cables is the reason everybody sees a lot of action.
Last year, in terms of
cable accidents, because since it's a passageway with several ships passing through and having many cables, there is always a chance that something would happen.
Let's talk a little bit more about some of the other market opportunities that are out there. And I'm thinking specifically of your stake in an Algerian telco, which hasn't quite panned out the way you would have liked. What's going on in Algeria? And are you going to stay there? Are you pulling out?
It has not been successful, and we rode it out completely. We accumulated this loss at 100% a couple of years ago, and the operation is non-existent.
So it was an unsuccessful venture then, looking at
it? It was not successful.
If there was an opportunity, would that opportunity be outside of the Middle East, possibly Africa? Seems to be a race for Africa going on.
So Africa is part of our territory, certainly, and we have the Nile that connects us to Uganda and connects us to Ethiopia, and we have a tradition and a life within Africa. We feel that we are part of Africa, and certainly markets in Africa are very exciting. So we share with Africa many things. In addition to the shoreline with the east coast of Africa, we also have a similarly young population as many of the African states do. Like I said, the waterway, the Nile.
So if there was an opportunity, it's more likely to be in Africa than anywhere else?
Middle East Africa, yes.